Hello and welcome to the last replay of the eligible winners of the how can I say it, the 1K YouTube sub competition, and this is the CV winner. It's Stress Possum from the Frag Clan, and he's playing the tier 10 American carrier. The am I here too slow? Sorry. Midway. And yeah, he had a pretty, I wouldn't say awesome, but pretty solid and good game. Was a bit close, but he was able to to do his best, let's put it like this. And since the requirement was a win, so you can imagine that it was a win anyways. But it was close at some point. Don't take everything for granted what I'm telling you here, because you know maybe by yourself that I'm not the best CV player. I would rather call myself maybe an average one, and nothing that at best. So what you can clearly see is that he's using his speed boost quite a bit, and the reason for that is probably to get as many strikes in as possible. He also, you will see it here now clearly, he's pre-dropping, so he's not going in with his whole, full squadrons. Okay, after he set probably a path on the minimap. Just to not lose too many planes in the beginning. That's a viable tactic. But if you're careful, you can also do it without it. But if you're, for example, going into heavy AA, like Wooster, Des Moines, Minotaur, so that's probably recommended to not lose too many planes in the start. Of course, you have limited planes, but the reloading time increases the more planes you lose. So you want to have as many planes available in the end game, or mid to late game, let's call it like this, to inflict as much damage as possible. Especially this drop here was very dangerous, because it's in the vicinity of a booster, which has absolutely good AA, and you wanna be wanna avoid to stick around too long in this AA clouds, or constant DPS in this case. But yeah, he's losing the terrain. The booster can't shoot over the island he was sitting at, and he also left. So he was able to drop the Jungmu there. Jungmu should have, in my opinion, immediately smoke up, but that's just me, if he goes in there. It's anyways a pretty risky move to go in from the mid, so I would have avoided that. But yeah, as you see, this here is the speed boost bar, so to say, and it's almost always at the lowest level. So he's using this to get the strikes in very fast. Mostly harassing the destroyers in the start. You can do that, that's absolutely okay, but you always look for targets of opportunities. Means, yeah, he dropped now the Chungmu, he doesn't bother to turn around. He's not going for the Prince Eugen. And he's, I assume at least, using the Tiny Tims on the attack planes. Yeah, and now the Prince Eugen is pretty low, so he goes in for another one. And it also clearly shows why you can't stay stationary, or shouldn't stay stationary in any ship when there are carriers around, because that gets you killed sooner or later. There is nothing that will change that, in my opinion. So always stay on the move, kind of, or close to other AA ships, and not like the Prince Eugen pretty much alone and then stationary. That's a death sentence in a carrier game. Alright, so again, this pre-dropping, so only two-thirds of the squadron are heading towards the enemy. And yeah, he's just constantly going or single out the target. The reason for that is pretty simple. In a carrier, you are damage dealer, a really, really good damage dealer, and you want to do that as often as possible. Poor Jungmu, even in the vicinity of a Wooster. This is kind of a thing that I don't like, that you are still able to drop these targets even though they are in the, like, in an area where, yeah, the AA power is really heavy, but okay, that's, yeah. You don't have these safe areas. In former times, you clicked, like, defensive AA with a Wooster, and the planes just fell out of the air, which is actually what it is supposed to be if you have a good AA ship, but, yeah. Sadly, that's not the case right now, so... Yeah, people have to suffer from it. And again, he's almost exclusively using, by the way, the attack planes and the dive bombers. So I assume he upgraded them to its max potential. He's rarely using the torpedo bombers. So he focused all the modules, maybe captain skills, on that two plane types, which makes sense. For on an Hakuryu, for example, I would like buff the torpedo bombers and the dive bombers, because the rocket planes are pretty, yeah, let's say mediocre at best. And on the midway, the torpedoes, yes, you have six of them, but they don't deal too much damage, and yeah, are just good for in occasional situations. Jungmu again spotted. I assume he might have radar, since he doesn't smoke up at all. So that's of course a problem, and maybe also a reason I wouldn't recommend using radar on the Pan Asian destroyers. It's really risky with all the carriers around. Yeah, and. He also was, I mean, he was in the vicinity of the Wooster, but that didn't help, or clearly didn't help. And now he's going in with a dive, torpedo bombers the first time. I guess he wants to reload, or give the squadrons of the attack planes and dive bombers a bit more time to recover, to fill up the damaged squadrons, so to say. Which makes sense. So he just uses the torpedo bomber occasionally, and I guess he doesn't mind to go into an AA area like this Des Moines here. Not sure if that's gonna work. I think the approach was a bit optimistic. Staying in that area is also a bit wonky, but as I said, he doesn't focus on the torpedo plane, so he's fine losing some of them, because he mainly strikes with the attack planes and dive bombers anyway. He hit in the end only one torp, so not very successful. I think I would have gone for a different target if I would be him. But yeah, you can sacrifice the planes, but you will do it in the late game. You will see this in this replay, that he will be a bit more, or will risk more of his planes in the late game, simply because he saved them up for it, which is absolutely a logical, yeah, behavior. And I would recommend to do that as well. Early game is just, yeah, setting some fires. You see he's leaving the Yamato again and goes for the Tirpitz now to set maybe their fire. So just to like spread this dot damage everywhere. And yeah, he's lucky again, another fire. And maybe goes even for the Iowa here, it looks like. Yes, he does. And sets even two fires, so you can always now go for them, these targets. And if they put out the fires, you can set permanent fires on them. It's now going in with the dive bombers, probably helping out Hassel with a fighter, I assume, to to help him out. Zao started his fighter plane a bit too late, in my opinion. Ah, no. He doesn't leave a fighter yet. Well, okay, the enemy bailed anyway, so... didn't matter for that reason. So it looked as if the Yamato put out the fire, or it ran out, I don't know. So if he damage count, then he will enjoy, depending on RNG, another fire that sticks for a while. Not the case. And Stress Possum thinks, okay, leave that Yamato behind. I'm going for the Tirpitz. But yeah, it's all about setting the stop damage and then return and get more of them in. By the way, if you're wondering, the reticle is not shown in the replay, which is like a bit sad, but it's how wargaming replays work apparently. So, can't say anything about the drop, when to drop, and so on. I'm too unexperienced myself. Yeah, this is questionable by the Tirpitz. He probably didn't deal or didn't think too much about what happens if you put out the fire immediately. Engaging enemy. And allows Stress Possum, maybe, if he's unlucky, yep, to set a permanent fire. So that was, of course, not the smartest play by the Tirpitz. That's everybody sees that for sure. So far his team is a bit behind in points, but it looks really equal unless something really weird is happening. And he's going on another trip with the attack planes. Not sure which targets he will attack. Des Moines, Montana. Looks like Montana. Since the other group down there is running and the Henri is chasing them down. Yeah, he's going for the Montana. And his friendly Yamato is showing quite a bit too much broadside to the enemy Yamato, in my opinion. Should have stayed where he is. As the fire turns away, because Conqueror has pretty good AA, Des Moines has pretty good AA, and he ends up in another precarious situation with the carrier around. I think I would have pulled my planes already back. Yeah, that was unnecessary, really unnecessary. He lost a full squadron there without a reason. It was a mistake. Now his attack planes will take some time to recharge, but then he's bringing out the torp bombers again. As I said, they are just the the time filler when the other squadrons recover, basically. All right, friendly Yamato killed the enemy Yamato, which is the thing, but gets finished off by the Zao, so can happen. At least he traded one for one. This is always good. And now it doesn't look too bad for Stress Possum's team anymore. Now the question is, what is he doing? Okay, he's starting the attack run early, which makes sense. Conqueror and Montana A are definitely no slouch, but he can make it through. And I guess he's going for the next strike on the Audacious. He doesn't want to stay too long in this area. Yeah, 5 torpedo hits, pretty awesome. And now I think he will probably pull them back. Yes, he does. And goes in with another strike. Again, attack planes, okay. Thought they would recover, but they apparently don't. Map positioning wise, this team is pretty in a good spot. You see the Zhao here, you can harass these guys. This Zhao can harass, and the Kurfürst and Musashi are taking the damage, so they are tanking for the team, which is obviously the best choice. Montana is about to go down, so he's going for the Conqueror, which makes also absolutely sense. Yeah, seven hits for 12k. Ouchie boombouchie. And yeah, Dive Bomber's next. Let's see which target he's flying to. It looks as if he's going for the Zhao because the Zhao is coming really close. Also, he's moving with the team, which is also really important since you have to. Or. Carriers are always good when it comes to like supporting your team with AA because they have the strongest AA, they have always planes in the vicinity. So, if you want to help your team in the late game when they are under attack from enemy carrier, just go close to the to your ships to help them out with AA cover fire. And here, as I said, he's going in for the risky things. That was really, really, really problematic drop, and he's running out of resources more or less. So that cost him quite a bit. So he's going in with the torpedo bombers again. So already not full squadrons anymore. He's also presenting himself as a target, which is also okay. HE fire doesn't hurt him too much. It takes simply too long to whittle down a CV with HE and fires. The automatic damage con, then the really, really short duration of the damage con. Doesn't make it viable, so you want to get the broadside of a CV. Two more torpedoes hit on the Zhao, and he's already at 225,000 damage. I guess the next drop will kill the Zhao, depending on the aim. Always in this last part of the approach, don't use the WASD. Yeah, nice kill there. WASD keys, just go with the mouse because if you use WASD, your planes will get or the pattern of the drop or the drop pattern will yeah alter too much and the spread will be wider. So that's, I don't know. For some of you who are maybe not so experienced with it, that's a thing. That's why you should approach from a longer distance with your torpedo bombers, for example. With dive bombers and attack planes, not so much, but for torpedo bombers especially, it's really important to do that. Sleeving a fighter is supposed to light up the Audacious for his team, so they have something to shoot. This drop is probably not going to hit. See? Yeah, two torpedo hits, still pretty good. Now going in with the dive bombers again, and so on and so on. If you look at the timer, it's 47 seconds. 790 to 772 points. I think he leaves now fighters over the Musashi, so he's safe from the enemy attacks, or more or less safe, and starts another plane immediately to set another fighter on the Musashi because he can't let the Musashi die, otherwise he will lose the game. I mean, probably not going to happen since only 15 seconds left, but safe is safe. And yeah, he wins the game finally with 240,000 damage. Two kills, a lot of torpedoes actually, 19 14 fires, so he was also blessed with the RNG there. And yeah, did overall a pretty good job. And that's why he's the winner. Also fulfilled all the requirements. So 210,000 damage was the damage requirement. If you look at the achievements, High Caliber, Confederate and Witherer. 2.5k base XP was the requirement base XP wise. And if you go over spotting damage, he spotted for 133,000, in which 80,000 would have been the number that you had to pass. So he fulfilled all the requirements, which is fine. And yeah, congratulations, Stress Possum. You're also eligible for air supply or premium air supply container code, which consists of three of these containers. And yeah, hope the best. I will announce the the winners will be announced on Discord, and I will send out the prizes by today or tomorrow. Depends how I can manage it. And yeah, hopefully you guys had enjoyed also the video. Maybe you could learn something. Maybe if correct me if I was wrong in some certain explanations. As I said, don't take everything for granted what I tell you here, since I'm not the master of CVs. All right, yeah. Thanks for watching, and bye-bye.